Hey everyone, this is Nick, and I wanted to jump on really quick and show you a very cool website that I learned about from Yulia Barnikova over at PowerPoint Spice on her channel here on YouTube. I want everybody to go there and subscribe to it. These tips are freaking amazing. I'm so excited to have seen this video and to have learned about this because I had an immediate use case for it. So right here on the slide, I have an image. This is an image of a group of icons. I can make it bigger. You can see it gets really pixelated and grainy. This is from a recent client project that I did, and they had these custom icons. They wanted to be able to edit them in different ways. But we couldn't do that. Even if you save this out as an SVG, a scalable vector graphic, even if you ungroup these, they're still images. Each of the individual people here and the icons are still images, and you can't recolor them like you can with shapes, or you can't resize them and do things like that. So you can see here when I select it, only the picture format tab comes up here in the ribbon. If these were editable graphics, then it would the graphics tab would have popped up too, or the format shape tab would have popped up too, and then I could color each of these individually, but I can't do that. So Yulia presented a website called Vecterizer.ai, and right now it's free in beta, but I also created an account. Now all you need to do is take that photo file, wherever it may live, and just drag it onto the site. It's going to go ahead and it's going to make, on this side you have the original, on the left side you have the original image, on the right side you have the vectorized result, and you can already see the quality is so much better because we know vector images are not made of pixels. They're kind of just infinite shapes and lines, and you can make them as large or as small as you want, and you never lose quality with a vector image. So right now I'm just going to go ahead and click download. And it has turned that PNG image into an SVG. I can actually export it as an SVG, and that's what you want to do if you want to be able to edit your shape. There's a bunch of other settings here that I didn't have to mess with. I think that you could play around with those on your own if you like, if there's some other things that you can do in terms of editing it in directly in Vectorizer. But I'm going to go ahead and download it, and then it'll open. It'll show where you added it. I'm going to go ahead and just drag that image into my PowerPoint file. Now already, this is the SVG image that we exported. You can already see the quality is so much better. It's much crisper. Now the thing is, when I click on it, I can't edit the individual people icons, but that's because it's an SVG image. It's all grouped together. So we have to ungroup this. So I'm gonna right click, go to the group menu here and say ungroup, and I'm gonna click yes. And now you can see it has actually ungrouped everything. So everything in this icon group is now its own individual shape. So if I wanted, I'm actually going to just say Shift-Control-C. That copies the formatting of this. And I'm going to do Shift-Control-V, and that copies the formatting there. And you can do Control-Shift-V, and that'll copy the formatting there. Now, all of these are individual. Now, I could just go ahead and group everything, Control-G to group. And then if I wanted to just now make this a different color, I could go up to the Shape Format tab and do this. Now, this is great because now when you highlight this new group, the SVG object, you can see that the Shape Format tab pops up instead of the Picture Format tab. And so this is an awesome way that you can start editing and formatting shapes and pictures that you might have that you weren't able to do before. You can just go ahead and drag any picture that you have or any image that you have into that Vectorizer site, and it will create these vector graphics that you can then edit. So thank you so much, Yulia, over at PowerPoint Spice for sharing this tip. I hope you all go over and subscribe, and I also hope you subscribe to my channel. Every time I find these little tips and tricks on LinkedIn or otherwise online, I will go ahead and share them and how I may have used them in my own work as well. So I hope you subscribe to my channel. Hit the bell next to it. You'll get notified every time I post a new video in data design, Excel, usually Excel, PowerPoint, or Word. I hope you all have a great day, and I can't wait to see you next time.